Let's start a new project using the MIP library template and name it Event Trigger. First, we will go to the designer mode to define the graphical components. This application needs an item picker, so we need a button with a pick an event for the text. Then, as before, we will use two labels to indicate the selected event. We also need a way to trigger the selected event, so we will add one more button with the text Trigger. We will also set it to Disable at first, until an event has been selected. Next, we double-click the Item Picker button to create the event code. The code looks almost identical to the one from the previous exercise. Here, we enable the trigger button when an event is selected. We also need to add the member variable for the selected item. Let's go back to the designer view and double-click the trigger button. In the code, we insert a single line of code to trigger the event in the XProtect VMS. We use the postMessage method to send the message and will, of course, include the FQID of the selected item as one of the arguments. Now we can save the application and run it. We'll move the application to one side of the screen and open the Event Listener application as well. Now we can see both applications. Let's select an event that we want to trigger and then click Trigger a few times. It seems to be working. Let's try another event. It is also working correctly. We can also select an event in the Event Listener application to verify it works. Test event 2 will not show because it's not the one we're listening for. Test event is the one we're listening for. Works as expected.